Hello and welcome to the channel. In this video, we'll be going over how to use complex selectors with Unity's stylesheets. Complex selectors will allow you to be more specific in which elements you wish to style. So first, we should learn a bit about specificity. I'll demonstrate this as an example, so I'll just create some selectors. So here are the four simple selectors we learned last time, which are the wildcard selector, the C# type selector, the USS class selector, and the assigned name property selector. Now, when an element matches multiple selectors, the selector with the highest specificity will take precedence. So first, to demonstrate this, I'm going to make an element which can be affected by all four of these simple selectors. Name this one my element, and I'll drag the red USS class to this my element. Now you can see in the matching selectors that all four elements will apply to this selector. Going to change the size of this element so it'll be more apparent. Now, I'm just going to assign a style to all four of these selectors and we'll see which ones take precedence. I'll do this simply by just changing the background color. Just remember that visual element and the wildcard selector is going to also affect the root visual element, so that's why I just created the size so you have this little box here, and we're mainly just going to look out for the changes in this box. So first I'll change the background of the wildcard to black. Then I'll change the background of the visual element to blue. Now I'll change the background of the red USS class to red. And finally, I'll change the background of the named property selector to green. Now you can see as I went down the list, the one that came after has higher precedence than the one which came before it. So from this, we can see that the C# type selector has more specificity than the wildcard selector, and the USS class selector has more specificity than the C# type selector, and finally, the assigned name property selector has more specificity than the USS class selector. So to be more specific in which element we want to target with our styles, we can use complex selectors. First complex selector we'll use is multiple selectors. Basically, a multiple selector consists of two or more simple selectors that aren't separated by a space when you type it out. So I'll create one called visual element and this selector here is a combination of the C# type selector as well as the name selector used in tandem. There's just no space in between. So we can show that this is more specific than just the name selector by just change the background color again. I guess I'll make this magenta. Now you can see that the attributes of this complex selector has taken precedence because it has more specificity than just the name selector by itself. I'll just delete this one now. I'll create another example of multiple selectors by just using the name as well as the asterisk, the wildcard symbol. Now, if I just change this to orange, you can see that that combination also has higher specificity over just the name by itself, even though it would practically achieve the same result as having just the name. I'll delete this one. However, there are situations where the UI system can't pass the multiple selectors. I'll give you an example. So this time we'll do the name, and we'll use the C# type selector and visual element. And you can see that if I just try and change the color, it won't affect the element at all, because it's essentially interpreting this as just a really long name called my element, visual element. Delete this. This also won't work if we just try this. Dot red visual element. I just try and change the color again. You can see it's not able to interpret this as a multiple selector, it's just interpreting it as a USS class called Red Visual Element. I'll delete this. So the easiest selectors that the multiple selector, complex selector can pass is the USS class selector, the assigned name property selector, and the wildcard selector. Because basically they all get prefixed with a special character, whereas wildcard selector is just the asterisk by itself. The next complex selector we'll look at is descendant selectors. First I'll just clear out this hierarchy and I'll just delete these. So to demonstrate this, I'll just drag a visual element into the hierarchy and I'll make a button a child of the visual element. Now this time, we'll use a descendant selector, and I'll just rename this button to my button. I'll add a selector, and we can see what the syntax is when I type it out. So first selector will be visual element. Then we add in a space to separate the selector. And our second selector will be my button. On the top left, it doesn't look like there is a space in between those two selectors, but if we look at in Inspector, there is a space present in the selector pane. So let's just style this button. We'll just give it a background color, I guess. Blue. And if you see, if I just resize this, 500 by 100. Width of this one to only be. You can see that the only thing being affected is the button itself. So with descendant selectors, it'll match the criteria of the first selector. And then the second selector. So it doesn't actually have to be a direct descendant. This button could be like a grandchild of this visual element. Let me demonstrate that. Grandchild now. Yeah. And you can see it's still being affected by this descendant selector. Perhaps as a better example, I'll just make it grandchild by parent making a child of this label instead. So you can see it is not directly descending from visual element. Next, I'll create just a more complex example. So I'll delete this. I'll recreate it. So we have this. I'm just going to create another red USS class and apply it to the visual element here. Now we're just going to combine multiple selectors with the descendant selectors in order to select this My button here. So just to show that it works, I'll rename this to My element. So I'm going to go for My element, which belongs to the red USS class. And I'll choose a button with the name of My button. Now, if I change the color here, see that it's been properly selected. Although for some strange reason, the name doesn't correctly show up here in the select pane. Save the file. And if we look at the USS, you can see that the name has been fully typed out. Back in the UI Builder, if I add another visual element here, and then I child a new button to it, and I name it My button, you can see that through the descendant selector, that'll also affect this other button, which is actually a grandchild of My element. So to make it that we affect the direct descendant of the primary selector, which would be this button here, we'll use a complex selector known as a child selector. To demonstrate the syntax, I'll just rename this selector. So instead of using a space to separate it, we will use an angle bracket, which is surrounded by spaces on both sides. I'll just save this and we can see it better in the USS. So, first selector, then just use a right angle bracket in between, and then your following selector. We can see that this other button now only conforms to this selector here. Select it. You can see its visual element, My button, and no longer being affected by this one. Whereas this button here is being selected by this selector here. As a final demonstration, I'm just going to show that you aren't limited to just having two parameters for a complex selector. That is, you aren't limited to just having a primary and then a secondary selector. Demonstrate that, I'll just create this hierarchy. Grandparent. Orphan. Like that. This. So, in order to affect these buttons, which we just named Orphan, we're going to put in this large selector. Start off with grandparent, choosing the direct descendant of parent, and also choosing the direct descendant of child. Then allowing to choose any descendant from child, which is called orphan. And I'll just change the background color to this. And I'll just open the USS. And you can see that I've got primary argument, a secondary argument, tertiary argument. I don't know what you call the fourth argument, but quaternary argument. We can continue to add arguments to refine our descendant we eventually wish to select. Although, with good foresight, your use of complex selectors shouldn't have to become so complicated. That brings us to the end of this video. I hope you've been able to follow along with this demonstration of how complex selectors can work. For further information, I have left a link to the official documentation on complex selectors. For now, this is the end of the video, and I hope to see you in the next one. Peace.